Hello students, in previous lecture we have studied about the thermal and magnetic properties of solids and we have also discussed about some semiconductive properties of solids. In this lecture we are going to understand what is capacitance and what is the dielectric strength. So let's start with the capacitor first. These are the some images of the capacitor, or these are the different type of the capacitor with different capacities. Very first, where these capacitors are being used in our daily life. So if we see in our daily life, many home appliances, something like fan, TV, air conditioning, mobile phones are using these capacitors in different capacities. Obviously, these are not obvious to you all because these are installed inside your appliances or inside your devices. Okay, and this, if we see the representation in electronic symbols, this can be represented by two parallel lines in this way. This is called the fixed capacitor. Once these capacitors are polarized, then it can be represented by a positive sign. And if these are variable capacitors, variable capacitor, the capacity is being varied, so then can be represented by a arrow line plus two parallel lines. These are the representation of it. So let's come back to the point where what is capacitance. So the capacitance is the ability of a body to store an electrical charge. So we are this is like capacitance. We just compare capacity and capacitance. So this device or this part is the ability to store the electrical charge, so it, because it is a part of electronics, so we can say this is the equipment of this, not equipment, this is the device which can store the electric charge. Okay, so a material with a capacity holds more electric charge at a given voltage than one with low capacitance. So always a capacitor with high capacity is always storing a higher amount of the charges compared to the capacitor with low capacity, right? So any object that can be electrically charged exhibits capacitance. However, the concept is particularly important for understanding the operation of capacitor, one of three fundamental electronic components. Okay, so these are three fundamental electronic components which can be represented as a capacitor. Okay, so now you understand, this is the electronic device which has the ability to store the electric charge. Okay, and other than this daily life, we can also see the application of it to storing the energy, power factor corrections, and coupling tuning. Coupling and tuning, this can be used in your radios or FM stations, where we use to tune the our FM stations. Okay, so these are the applications. This is the just limited I have mentioned here, but there are lot of applications. Let's understand some important points about these capacitors. Generally, these capacitors are known as condensers in market. Okay, and these are two terminal devices, right? These are always two terminal electrical component and used temporarily store the electrical energy in electric field. Okay, these capacitors cannot be used as your inverter, which is like storing your energy for the long time, right? So this can be used to store the energy for momentary, right? For a moment, few moments, right? Not for a long time. The forms of practical capacitors are widely, but most contain at least two electrical conductors, plate separated by a dielectric. We will discuss it how these are configured in next slide. Okay, second, the conductors can be thin film, so these are also formed in thin film format, foils, sintered beads of metal, or conductive electrolytes. So these are different materials, so it can be formed by thin films, foils, sintered beads of metals, or conductive electrolytes, right? Materials commonly used as a dielectric indels, glasses, ceramic, plastic, paper, mica, and oxide layer. So these are formed by some dielectric materials as well. So these are some example of dielectric materials. Other than capacitors are widely used as a part of electrical circuits in many common electrical devices. I just gave you the example, for example, in the mobile phone or in most of the common electrical devices, these components are always used, right? There is another opponent component, if you might have said, there's a resistors. So these are two different component of electrical devices, resistor and capacitor. Now you get it. Resistors is always what is suppress the, or it never store the energy, right? But the capacitor always store the energy, right? So these are two different component. Unlike a resistor, an idle capacitor does not dissipate the energy. So which I just discussed, resistor can never dissipate the energy or never store the energy, right? Instead, a capacitor store energy in the form of electrostatic field between its plates. We will discuss it further. This is the very basic configuration of a parallel plate capacitor. You see, I use the word parallel plate capacitor because here two plates are parallelly aligned and separated a distance by L. These is separated by a distance L. And it is filled with a vacuum. There is no other material is filled between these two parallel plates. Okay, and this is connected by a battery. If you see a battery, so positive voltage is connected to the positive terminal is connected to the top plate, and while the bottom plate is connected to the negative terminal. Okay, and how we can define the capacity of this capacitor? So this is the driven by a formula C is equal to Q over V. Okay, Q is the charge. Okay, charge accumulated at any of the plate, and V is the applied voltage. So it will be represented by Q by C, and the unit is always in farad. Okay, this can be represented, the unit is always farad. Okay. So this can also be represented by C is equal to epsilon naught A over L, right? Epsilon naught is the permittivity of the vacuum. Because there is a vacuum between these two plates, so this is the permittivity of a vacuum. While A is the area of these plates. This is the area of these plates. While L is the distance between these two plates, correct? So this is the capacity. This is the way to represent a capacity of a capacitor. So if we see from here, so always see capacitance is always depend on the amount of the charge stored on these plates. Higher the charge stored on these plates will give the higher capacitance of this capacitor. Second, it is inversely proportional to the voltage. So to get the higher capacitance, we need to reduce the voltage of it. Second, if we see, we can further improve the capacitance by increasing the area, right? If we have a large amount of the area of these plates, then definitely the storage capacity of this capacitor will be very high. While it is inversely proportional to the distance between these plates. So we have to keep the distance between these plates minimum, okay, to make the capacity of this capacitor higher, right? Okay, this is the capacitor where we have used only the vacuum. But let's say if we want to improve the capacity, so there is another way we can insert a dielectric medium or dielectric material between these two plates to improve the capacity. In that case, the formula will be changed from C is equal to epsilon naught A over L. You can see just here epsilon naught has changed to epsilon because we have just inserted a dielectric medium. So epsilon naught will change to the epsilon. This will epsilon will be the permittivity of the medium. It will be the permittivity of the medium, and which can be observed here, epsilon R is equal to epsilon over epsilon naught, where epsilon R will be the relative permittivity of this medium, or it is also called dielectric constant. Okay, if we see here, the dielectric constant here is directly proportional to the permittivity of the medium. So if we want to improve the capacity of this capacitor, we have to improve the dielectric constant of the medium or permittivity of the medium, because it is directly proportional to. If we don't want to change the value of A and L, we need to insert a material which has higher dielectric constant to improve the capacity of the capacitor. Let's understand the capacitance of a capacitor, how it varies through an example. This is the example. When a 4 microcoulomb of charge are placed on a conductor and the potential is 8 volt, what is the capacitance of this capacitor, right? So this can be represented like, okay, so we can calculate the capacitance is equal to Q over V using. So we just put the values of Q charge, with that will be the 40 microcoulomb divided by 8 volt. So the capacity of this capacitance will be 5 microfarad, correct? This will be 5 microfarad. So this is the way to calculate the capacitance of a capacitor. Okay. So let's understand the dielectric materials. So most of the capacitors exist in today's industry consist of the dielectric materials inserted between two parallel plates always, right? The material, dielectric materials, is always inserted between these two parallel plates of the capacitor. So what happens by inserting these materials, the capacity of a capacitor is increased. It means the charge storage capacity is increased. Okay, right. So the separation of the dielectric charge always allow more charge to placed on the plates and enhance the capacitance, right? Most of these materials, dielectric materials, are generally considered as glass, ceramic, plastic films, paper, mica, and oxide layers. These are the very common materials which are being used in capacitors. So let's understand what are the advantages of these dielectric materials in a capacitor. First is this enhances the capacity. I mean, we don't want to change the distance between the capacitor. Just inserting this material between these two plates, we can enhance the capacity of the capacitor. So a smaller plate disapparation without any contact, so it enhances the capacity. Increase the capacity of capacitor means that's the same thing. Higher voltage can be used without the breakdown. So because we have improved the capacity of a capacitor, so then higher voltage can be used and the capacitor won't break down. Often it allows for the greater mechanical strength. It is because these are the dielectric materials, and sometimes these dielectric materials has the higher mechanical strength. So it will also provide the higher mechanical strength to the capacitor. Let's understand the dielectric constant of a material, which can be represented by epsilon r. Okay. Generally, what is it? What this dielectric constant of a material can be represented by the ratio of the capacitance C with this material as compared to the capacitance C0 in vacuum. So please take a note. It is the ratio of the capacitance C with this material, means when this material is inserted between two parallel plates, okay, as compared to the capacitance C0 in vacuum, when it means when there is no material, okay, only vacuum exists between the parallel plates. So in the formula, it can be represented by epsilon r. Here is the this is epsilon r is equal to C over C0, where the epsilon r, the value for the epsilon r will be equal to 1 for air. So it means C and C0 will be equal when the when air is inserted between these two parallel plates, right? So this can also be further explained in terms of V0 and V. V0 is the voltage when the vacuum is inserted between parallel plates, while V is the voltage when dielectric material is inserted between the parallel plates of the capacitor. So how we can get this equation from the top equation? Let's see. You remember the previous equation where we saw, okay, let me get the selection. Okay, so just give me a moment, please. So you remember the equation C is equal to Q over V, correct? Where, let's say V is same when either in either the case when it is in a vacuum or it is in material. When Q is same, so what is going to have, C is inversely proportional to V. So let's say there will be two condition. One will be C is equal to Q over VZ naught. I just put it V naught, right, in case of vacuum. While another will be C is equal to when dielectric material is inserted, Q over V. When, what will we do? So if we divide the equation, we will put the value of C and C naught A here in this equation. So what will happen? We will get Q will be cancelled out Q. So it will gives up epsilon R is equal to V0 over V in that case. Correct? Second, then how we'll get this equation? It will be equal to V0 over V. So we remember the formula from class 12, always V is equal to E over D, right? In either of the case, D is equal, either in vacuum or materials, D is always equal. So what will happen? V is directly proportional to E. So the electric field obtained in the capacitor in case of vacuum, this will be E0. So it will be represented by E0, and it will be similarly, E will be the electric field when the dielectric materials is inserted in the capacitor. Correct. So this is the representation how we can get epsilon R is equal to E0 over E. Right. This will also be equal, this epsilon R can also be represented by epsilon divided by epsilon naught. So we have discussed this equation in our previous slide. So from here, if we see the epsilon means dielectric constant of the material will equal to permittivity, instead of dielectric constant, it is the permittivity of the material will equal to epsilon into epsilon r, epsilon naught into epsilon. So it will be epsilon is equal to epsilon r into epsilon naught, where the value of epsilon naught means the permittivity of vacuum will be 8.85 into 10 to the power minus 12 farad meter inverse. Take a note, this is the value, right? You have to remember this value carefully because it is needed always for the formula. So hope this is clear now. Let's understand how this dielectric material is going to influence the electrical parameters in capacitance. So electric, let's say when there is no dielectric material is inserted, there is no dielectric material inserted, then value of the capacitance is C0, voltage is V0, electric field E0, and dielectric constant is epsilon naught. Okay, so let me change it to the point. Yeah, so this is the value where the dielectric constant is not inserted, dielectric material is not inserted, is in its vacuum. Okay, while when the dielectric material is inserted between these two parallel plates, the C0 changes to C, V0 changes to V, electric field E0 changes to E, and epsilon naught changes to epsilon. Take a note, the charges on the capacitor remains constant. We keep the charges on the parallel plates constant. So how it is going to influence it? So we saw, because this is, remember we discussed previously, when a dielectric material is inserted between a capacitor, it enhances its capacity to store the charges, right? It means the capacitor or capacitance always increases, correct? The capacitance increases. So if we go from here first, so if you see, the capacitance is always enhanced, right? Always the permittivity of the dielectric material is higher than the permittivity of vacuum. So this is the second case, permittivity is always increased. Now third case, because C capacitance is always inversely proportional to the voltage, we saw over there. So this is the equation, if you remember, C is equal to Q over V, right? So I just write it down one more time. So this is C is equal to Q over V from this equation, right? So because the Q here is constant, both the Q is constant, it means the C is inversely proportional to V. So because C is increased here, it means the voltage will be dropped compared to the capacitor where vacuum is inserted between these two plates, right? And third case or final case, V is always proportional to the E. In the previous slides we just discussed, EV is equal to E over D. So voltage is always proportional to the electric field. So V will also be reduced in that case when the dielectric material is inserted between these two plates of the capacitor. Okay. Let's discuss how the energy is stored in the capacitor. Very first, this energy is always measured in joule. Okay, whatever the energy is stored in the capacitor, it is always measured in joules. And what is it? It is equal to the work required to push the charges into the capacitor. Okay, is that to charge it? So what it would be the work? We can say the energy is stored. So this will be the amount of the work. Let's say this is the capacitor over here. I have plus Q charge over here on the one plate and another minus Q charge on the another plate, right? So whatever the amount of the charge, amount of the work needed to insert the charge in this capacitor, okay, will be counted as the work, okay, stored energy or counted as the work, which will be stored in the form of energy, right? So let's say this is plus Q charge on the one plate, another charge on the minus Q, and we assume there is a very small charge on this, let's say very small charge on this plate, plus dQ, right? That's the dQ, small charge dQ. Okay, we want to shift this charge or insert this charge from the one plate to another plate. We just take this to one plate to another, so we have to work, right? We need to work to carry this charge from one plate to another. So how we can find it out how much work is done? So this can be represented by dW is equal to Q over C into dQ. This will be the amount of the work to shift or to move a small amount of the charge dQ. Okay, so against the potential, so we need to, because there will be a potential, because this is the plus Q minus Q, so against the potential, what will be the potential? V is equal to Q over C. This will be potential, so we have to work against this potential to store this charge. Okay, so this will be dW is equal to Q over C into dQ. Okay, so this will also be, again, this will also be measured in the joule. Okay, so how we can get it, the total charge? So what we need to know, we just need to integrate it, right? We just need to integrate it to get the total work done. Okay, to charge it. And how much will be the total work? So we just assume, let's say assume first this capacitor, right? This capacitor is totally discharged, means the amount of the charge or energy stored in this capacitor is zero. When we are going to charge it, we are inserting charges inside. We are going to inserting, pause, let's say plus Q charges or plus dQ charges slowly. We are inserting plus dQ charges slowly. And once it is inserted, so at when it is fully charged, it will go from Q is equal to 0 to Q is equal to capital Q. We assume the total charge after fully charged, it will be capital Q. So we will integrate it from Q is equal to 0 to plus Q. That will be the total work done. Okay, we need to integrate it. So let's see how we are going to integrate it. So here is the how we can get the work done in charging this capacitor. From charge Q is equal, when it is completely discharged, means it does not have any charge, total charge is 0, to charge Q. Okay, we just integrated to get the work done is, or amount of the energy is stored inside this capacitor. This will be equal to the work done on this capacitor. So this is simple mathematics from class 12. So we can get it 1 over 2, okay, 1 over 2 Q square over C. So we will get it. So putting the limits of it, so we can get it. This is simply mathematics. After that, this can also be further represented by 1 over T Q V. Okay, how it can be? C is equal to Q over C, right? I just put the value of C here, then I can get it QV, because one Q will cancel out this Q, and this is denominator, it will go to the up. So it will be QV, right? This is the same equation. Third, the third format, this can also be represented 1 over 2 CV square. How? Because using the same equation here, right? We do use the same equation. So Q will be equal to CV from here. From this equation, it means C is equal to QV. So Q will be equal to C, sorry, this will be not C, this is V. Okay, this will be C into V. So we just put the value of Q here, this will be CV square. So this will be amount of the energy stored. So there are three form of the work. This will be 1 over 2 Q square over C. This will be second format QV, half QV, and third will be half CV square. There are three different format of the amount of the energy stored in the capacitor. Okay, so let's understand how we can apply these equation to calculate the amount of the energy stored in a capacitor. So for we understand this by an example. Let's say the capacitor, we have a capacitor which have 1 farad and it can be charged up to 100 volt, and calculate the stored energy in the capacitor in joule. Okay, so we know the equation, right? We know the equation, Q is equal to CV. We put this value of capacitance and voltage, 1 farad into 100 volt. So the amount of the charge, maximum amount of the charge will be 100 coulomb. Okay, because we need to calculate the stored energy. So stored energy will be in the form of work done. So it will, because we have capacitance and voltage, so we can use the formula W is equal to half CV square. So we put these values, we can directly get these values from here, 1 by 2, 1 volt into 100 volt. So the work done will be equal to 5000 joule. Other than that, we can also use the second formula, which is W is equal to half Q square over C. Q we have calculated here. So it will be, if we put the values, we will still get the same answer. We can still use the third formula, which is equal to half QV, right? We put those values here, Q value which I have calculated here, and the voltage which has been given here. So the result will still be same. So we can use either of the formula, okay, to calculate the amount of the energy stored in this capacitor. So this is the application of these equations to calculate the capacity of a capacitor. So this is the end of this topic. So in this topic, we have understand the basic concepts of capacitance and dielectric constant, right? These are two important factors. So I just repeat it. Capacitance is the capacity of a capacitor to store the charges. Okay, this is the like a one best example is parallel plate capacitor, where the two plates are separated by a certain distance, right? In standard, or we can say in initial state, first we can consider is where there is a vacuum, okay, between these two plates, right? Okay, it has a certain amount of the capacity. Let's say if we want to enhance the capacity of a capacitor, we have to insert a material, which is we generally call it dielectric material. So dielectric material, when we insert the dielectric material, the capacity of a capacitor is enhanced, so it can store a more amount of the charges. Okay, so it is going to influence its capacity, its electric field, it is voltage, it's a voltage. Okay, okay, other than that, we can calculate, we understood or we discussed the how we can calculate the amount of the energy that is stored inside this capacitor. This can be calculated by calculating the work done to charge this capacitor from charge Q is equal to zero when it is in discharge condition to it fully charged when it is storing Q amount of the charge. So that will be equal to 1 by 2 C into V. It also have two other formats. After that, we also learned how we can apply these formulas to calculate the amount of the stored charges. Hope all these topics are clear to you. If you're not, please go through this lecture again. Okay. Thank you very much.